talking is getting slow.
Sisterhood Radio on iAccessRadio.com. What's up? It's LaRock on the radio. And guess what? I am solo today on the Sisterhood Radio. My sis, my BFF, my roll dog, my Lady Bex is all booed up this weekend. Her and her husband are celebrating their fifth anniversary, so yay for them. So they went away for the weekend, so that leaves me, LaRock, right here, all by myself. But that's all good, because I'm going to need you guys to call in, have a good conversation. It's going to keep the conversation rolling as usual. It's business as usual. This is the Sisterhood Radio, and we're right here in the studio talking about whatever we like today, okay? I called a lot of us up this evening asking for topics. I feel like kind of like my left arm is gone or something. I need my Lady Bex to like call in or something. This is the Sisterhood Radio. How can I help you? What's up? It's the Sisterhood. It's LaRock.
Hey, it's
Lady Bex. What's up, Lady Bex? Oh my goodness, girl. It don't feel like anything without you, boo. Where are you?
It's my anniversary, guys.
Yay. Well, happy anniversary.
Thank you.
And we are, I'm happy. I'm so, yes, please.
What's the topic today?
Listen, we're talking about, it's a relationship topic. We're talking about the situationship. So we're going to need all your people to call in. Please text your friends. Everyone out there who's listening, text your friends. Tell them to call in. The number to call in is 347-708-0216. It is the Sisterhood Radio. We are live from the Bronx. We're live in the car with Lady Bex. That's right. Let me talk about Jersey. Big shout out to Jersey right now. I represent Jersey all day, every day. Shout out to Bergen County, Teaneck, Inglewood, Hackensack, Patterson. That's not that's county, but shout out to all of Jersey right now. We never get the credit. We never do. Especially we over here in New York. Please, they don't even care about us over here. But it's me. I'm here representing Jersey all day, every day. Call me right now, 347-708-0216. Call us. We'll talk about the situationship. We are live right now from the Bronx. Let me know that you call in. Bex, I don't know how long you could be on the phone, but I thank you for being here. I'm very happy that you're here.
See you guys later. I'll eat your situation food.
Okay. All right. Well, then call me later if you can, okay? All right. Thanks, Lady Bex. I'll switch the music. You can turn it up. Are we live on the air? Like, hot. Oh my goodness, we're still hot. What's up? I feel like, you know. Oh, here goes some music. Listen to Stevie for a little bit.
Some men only find in their dreams. When she smiles, it
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's LaRock on the radio. You have stopped at the sisterhood. Yay! We're here. It's just me all by myself today, but it's all good. I just said a couple moments ago that Lady Bex is all booed up this weekend with her husband. Happy anniversary to her. And guess what we're going to talk about today? We're going to talk about the single folks. We're going to talk about the ones that were not exactly booed up this evening or yesterday or this whole entire week. Talking about ones who may be in something called a situationship. And I notice the situationship is now an actual term. And if you don't know what a situationship, I'll tell you right now. It is a relationship that's not necessarily a relationship. That makes no sense, but it makes exact sense. And I bet you are or know someone who is in one. So let's talk about what's the situationship. It's a relationship between, you know, man and woman or whoever you want to, you know, lay your head down with. But there's no rules to it. You guys only have just one thing in common. You may hang out or whatever, but there's no rules to it. You know, you may travel with them. So just to tell you a personal story of mine in a situationship, it always leaves one person uncomfortable. I believe it does. It leaves one person wanting more than the other. One person might be totally about it, about the situationship. They're totally comfortable with just having a sexual relationship that absolutely means nothing except for sex, you know? And I see that's a lot. It's a lot going on when we do that. A lot of emotions getting involved in, you know? Do you post your situationship at all? Do you say, this is my boo, this is my girl, this is my man? Nope, you do not. Situationships don't get those luxuries, okay? Situationships are exactly what it is. You're in a situation and you have freedom basically to do what you want to do. And that's all has to be, like, I guess, agreed on with that person. But I'm finding that nowadays there's a lot of situations going on. No one wants to be in a relationship. Now, let me correct myself on that. I'm not going to say no one. I want to say there's perhaps a lot of men who rather have situationships than relationships. Now, if I'm wrong, call me up. Let me know. 347-708-0216. But I'm finding a lot of men do not want to have relationships. They just want to be in a situation. It just seems like it's easier for them. And I don't understand that. I don't know why. Why is it so easy? What's wrong with having some emotion in a relationship? You know what I'm saying? So I think a lot of men may be a little scared of that. They don't want to say that they're scared of it, but I truly believe that a lot of men are afraid of getting into that togetherness with somebody. Well, will they be hurt? I don't know. See, I'm not the right person to even talk about it because I've been handed down the worst. So I'm not going to talk in a positive light. That's why we need Lady Bex. She kind of evens me out, and I'm not trying to hate on anybody or talk negatively about any man. I'm really, really not. However, the situations that I've been in seems to be that some men are just scared. They do not want to have the responsibility of having emotion with anybody. And that's just, it's crazy. And I wonder where does that begin? How does that start? How can you not have that? Why are some men just afraid of love? Okay? Call me up at 347-708-0216. It's the Sisterhood Radio. We'll be right back. everybody. It's LaRock on the radio. I'm here right now on a Sisterhood Radio. Please call me at 347-708-0216. We're talking about situationships. Talking about it right now. What is a situationship? Can you give a better definition than I do? Because let me tell you what a situationship means to me. A relationship without any daggone emotion. And it seems as if women kind of settle on these relationships. Now, you could, you know, have a difference. You could be totally different than how I feel. And I want you to call and talk to me about that. Because I believe it's the truth. I know a lot of women who would like to be in a relationship, but instead of relationships, we're getting, you know, men who do not want to have their emotions involved. And that's an issue, okay? Especially women at certain ages. I mean, after 35 years old, like, how come you our guys are afraid of relationships? Is it just me? If it's just me, let me know. 347-708-0216. We're talking about situationships, the difference between situationships and relationships, okay? And if you've been in a situationship, you could be in right now. What's preventing you from being in a relationship with that person? If you spend a lot of time with that person, you are going out to movies, you're going away on vacations together, and you still not calling each other boyfriend and girlfriend? You still can't make it happen? I mean, what's the point? Is it your age? I'm finding a lot of men are over a certain age and still trying to play around like that. But why? Ladies, we're right in that same boat because we take it. We take the situationship, okay? We're good with not calling each other boyfriend and girlfriend. Or am I wrong? Let me know. This is LaRock on the radio. Call me up, 347-708-0216. Listen to Stevie Wonder. It's my favorite. I love him. Summertime, I think it was called, right? Yeah. Glass of wine or something. Hello, everybody. It's a rock on the radio, and we are back. Tonight, we're just going to take it easy with Stevie Wonder all night. You know, Stevie is like one of my favorite artists anyway. If you don't like a Stevie Wonder song, then I cannot be your friend. So unfriend me now on all social media. You have to love Stevie Wonder. Like, you really do. Do you need this? Oh, okay. You really do have to love Stevie Wonder. Talking about situationships. And so someone just sent me an article on it right now and talking about defining what the relationship actually is, right? All right, so let's go look at that. Please give me a call. It is 347-708-0216. Call me. Don't be shy. A lot of my friends are shy. I don't know why. We talk all the time. It's okay. You're in the comfort of your home. You could talk on the phone, say what you want, wear your bonnet. You know what I'm saying? Sit at home on your couch. Do your toes, something. You can call me. It's okay. You guys call me anyway. Call me at this number, 347-708-0216. We're talking about situationships. Are you in one? What is that all about? It's that love in me. Of love today. I could just do slow dance. Like all day. No. Again, so we're talking about situationships. So what is a situationship? We know it feels like a relationship, and to everyone else it may seem like one, but it's not, right? So the difference between a full-on relationship and a situationship, as Fabulous simply called it, as simple as it is, right? So relationships usually has a boyfriend-girlfriend title, okay? But it's not really solely defined as like one union, but there's titles involved. In a situationship, there is no title. It's just you're dating someone, okay? And it's basically no commitment to it. And so what do we want mostly out of relationships? We kind of love that commitment, right? So if we kind of fall into that category as situationship, we're just setting ourselves up, you know? That's not what we really want to go to. And I believe a lot of us fall into that. We find someone that we're attracted to, we like them, then we realize, well, this person doesn't want a relationship, and so we just settle for the situationship. Oh, he's not my boyfriend, we just hang out, right? But you hang out, but you're also having sex, right? You're having sex with them, you're hanging out, but you still have no commitment. How long can we go and do that, right? How long is that going to last? How can we build solid relationships if we're just going to just go throughout life like that? You know, do we play around a little bit? Yeah, we do. We do play around a lot. But how long can that even last? You know, there has to be something else out there just to be running through people all the time. So that sounds kind of harsh, but it's the truth. You know, life is short. You know, what's we need to build with people? And it's hard as it is trying to find just one person, you know? So let's try to build. Call me up, 347-708-0216. This is iAccess Radio. Did I say that? Oh my goodness. This is iAccess Radio. This is the Sisterhood Radio. We're live with LaRock. That's me. Oh my gosh. And Lady Bex is not here. I'm like crying inside, Lady Bex. You can't do this to me again. No more boot up weekends. You can't have boot up weekends. All right? Unless I go on a boot up weekend. With my boo, who doesn't exist. My ghost. That's my boo. My boo is my bed and my pillow. This is we're live right now. Give us a call. Hey, what's up? This is LaRock on the radio. This is the Sisterhood. How can I help you?
What's going on?
Hey, what's up?
How you doing?
Good. Hey, what's up? How you doing?
I'm doing all right. The topic is the time. What can I do?
The topic is what? Say it again.
I'm checking out the topic.
It's the situationships. You know, I'm talking, and in particular, I'm talking about how women wind up being in situationships. And I could be wrong, but in my perspective, we really don't want that. So, what do you think about that?
Some people don't know. Some people don't know who to find that, and some people don't know what type of relationship they're in because the communication, some people can't be honest with each person. So they never know.
Right.
They don't know how deep they are. Some people's emotions different than us before.
Right.
They get caught up on that.
Exactly. So, you know what I hate, though? I hate the word catching feelings. You know what I'm saying? I always, always, always hear this catching feelings. But my thing is, it is natural to catch feelings. I mean, if you laid up with somebody all the time, isn't it like, you're going to catch feelings for someone, right? And then obviously you want to maybe build with that person. Why are we so like used to, running away from what love? It seems like we're running away from that. Like, we'd rather just have something just easy, you know? So what do you think about
that? It's Depper Track 22.
Of course it is. Of course it is.
Some people, a lot of people don't know how to be honest. Some people think that, they act like they're in a relationship.
Uh-huh.
And one person assumes, and then you're caught up.
You know what
I mean? When the person do certain things, you can't fall back. You're already in.
Right. Of course this has probably gone on for centuries, right? But I feel like nowadays, I'm breaking up. You're breaking up. I feel nowadays that if you want to call back, you can. No problem. Just me and you and Al. I feel that nowadays people are more tuned to being in a situationship and being in a relationship. Why? Situationships, sex is involved, right? Usually it's good sex. That's why you keep on going back, right? So everyone's having this great sex. And also there's that thing of not being in a committed relationship, right? No one wants to deal with emotions. No one wants to deal with, people's attitudes. People just want to hit it and get it and just go. But I'm finding that we're losing ourselves when we do that, you know? People are losing each other when they do that. They're losing themselves when they do that. People just want to have, I know people want just to have fun, but is it really that much fun to be in a situationship? You know what I'm saying? Now we are the days of social media where everybody gets frustrated if your boo or your situation doesn't post you on Facebook, but they post somebody else on Facebook, right? Then everybody gets mad all of a sudden again. You know, what you said was right, was about communicate. Go ahead. Oh, you are.
You get me?
I don't know, but your Boost mobile phone is breaking up, though. I can't really hear you. You want to call back? Because we can't hear you.
Yeah, I'm going to call back.
Okay, call back.
All right.
Thank you, though. So, like I said, guys, situationships, there's something in it for you, right? But that's usually just sex, and that does complicate absolutely everything, right? And it's, although it can be fun, but emotions always get involved, and no one wants to get hurt. And I think that's the main reason why men in particular, yes, I did say that, are in situationships, because they don't want to be hurt. Now, would a man call me and debate me on that? Would a woman call me and debate me on that? Who knows? But you can call in 347-708-0216. This is the Sisterhood Radio. You're live right now. Well, I'm live right now. Fright from the Bronx. Lady Bex is booed up. She's definitely not in a situationship. She is in a glorious marriage. and celebrating her 5th year anniversary. We're listening live. This is Stevie Wonder on the radio. Call me.
Broken glass is everywhere. It's a bloody scene. Killing plagues the citizen.
You guys turn your radio down. What's up? It's the Sisterhood. Listen, when you call in, turn your radio down. Hello, it's the Sisterhood.
Hello.
Hi, you gotta turn your radio down, boo. I hear Stevie Wonder all over the place. It's like surround sound Stevie.
Hello.
Hi, what's up? It's La Rock on the radio.
How you doing today?
Great. Is this Wiz? Great. Who is this?
This is the only the instrument. Chris
Ali calling. Oh, hello, friend. It's a violator calling. What's up? How you doing?
I'm good. How you doing?
Oh, it's great. It's great. It's just me right now. My lady Bex is out. She's all booed up this weekend. So it's just me.
Happy anniversary.
Yes, happy 5th anniversary to Lady Bex. Chris Ali, what's up? So tell me what's up about the situationship talk. We're talking about
it. Relationships filled with the kids. I know my man Al will agree with me on that. Kids got situations. Men have relationships.
All right, I feel that. But I'm finding a lot of men of a certain age are still trying to be in a situationship. Tell me about that. Go ahead.
Well, I will say this. People get in situations because other people allow them to let it happen.
Ha. Huh.
So if you allow the situation to happen, then a man will run with it. If you don't have to commit, if you don't have to do nothing, and you're still going to be his boo, he's going to go along with it. But once you start putting your foot down and ask for what you want, then you're going to figure he's going to even step up to be a man.
Yeah.
Or he's going to leave the situation.
You know what? I feel like a lot of women are kind of even afraid of doing that. You know what I'm saying? Like, we will hold out for a very long time. What one thing, unfortunately, what women do, women settle. Women do settle. And I think until we reach a certain age, and usually it's, you know, a little bit up there, that we do like exactly what you said. We put our foots down. But I noticed in the younger generation, or even my, you know, our generation or whatever, that we do settle. We take what's given for us. We don't put our foot down. We just stay right in this spot, and we're unhappy in that place, and we settle for these situationships that end up nowhere. Situationships end up nowhere. They're dead ends. You know what I'm saying? And so an actual relationship, you know, we're building, you know, a foundation to pursue what? One day to get married or to have a family, whatever, in a relationship.
You know, a lot of times people don't even know what relationships
are. Huh. Okay.
And sometimes people get into it because, especially females, they start to feel this butterfly in their stomach and like, I'm in love.
Uh-huh.
And those butterflies, I would say those are caterpillars. And when those butterflies become a butterfly, it flies away.
Right.
So, and that's what happens. And I would say everybody gets in situations. Everybody doesn't really come with a real game face on when they come into a relationship. Because everybody doesn't know what to do in a relationship.
You know, I think that changes, though. I think that definitely changes when you know exactly what you want. You know what I'm saying? I think you do come with your game face. I think, like, you know what? This is what I want. And you got to be upfront about it. It's all about that communication. It's all about, you know, knowing what exactly what you want before you jump into something. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people, when you're talking to someone, if you don't say upfront, listen, I want a relationship, then it's going to happen. It's going to wind up being a situationship. You know what I'm saying? Because no one ever talks about it. No one ever says anything about it. You know? And then, like, you kind of hide from your honest feelings. Because now what the world is saying, what social media is saying, oh, people catching feelings. You got songs talking about catching feelings and all that stuff and falling back. All that nonsense. And we're getting away from, like, long-lasting relationships. All we want to do is, like you said, like, think like a kid and act like a kid. You know? But unfortunately, we're not children. You know, we're 40s and 50s, you're old, men and women still trying to be in situationships. And I don't understand.
They don't know. They don't know what a relationship is. They don't even know how to love themselves. Let's start there first.
Wow, yeah, that's true.
So once you start to understand how to love yourself, and also when you put God in the situation, and it's mixed, you start to understand how to have a relationship with someone else. But if you can't even have a relationship with yourself first,
yes,
then you lost, period.
That's absolutely right.
Those are the two first relationships you should have, with yourself and with God. And then after you move from there, everything else becomes easier.
Word up. You hear that, ladies? Do you hear that? That's what we talked about that a couple weeks back about self-love. We have to do that first. If we know that we want to have a relationship, okay, we know that we have to have that self-love first. That's coming from a man. Men know that, okay? Ladies, I'm going to need you to jump on board. I want you to know that. Chris, you stopping by the studio?
I was going to tell him, Beck was coming, I came up there.
Well, it's just literal me and Al, but we're doing a good job. Right. I thank you for calling, okay?
Yeah, I know.
But thank you for calling, all right? I appreciate you.
All right, take care.
All right, thank you. This is The Rock on the Radio. This is The Sisterhood. Call me, 347-708-0216. We're talking about situationships. We're talking about situationships. Had some good callers. We always have a lot of male callers. Ladies, are you afraid to come talk to me? Please don't come afraid talking to me. One thing that the violator who called in on the radio, he said you must love yourself and God first. And I truly believe that. If you want to get into any relationship. And I think a lot of women, older women are saying to themselves, you know, this is what I want. Now, I could be speaking for myself too, but I know, like for me, I know what I want, really, and I don't want any more situationships. You know, there's a way that they makes you feel at the end of the day. You know, for some reason, social media is like a trap. You know, social media always has you thinking, like under yourself, if that makes any sense, right? So what I mean by that, so like you ever see, you know, you go on social media and you start posting pictures, but do you post pictures with your significant other? Does it make a difference? You know what I'm saying? And it's big issues. People have arguments over stuff like this, okay? Well, how can you even take a picture of me? Yo, it's real serious. These are grown people talking like this. How come I'm not pictured, you know, in your profile pic, but you pictured it with your boys? True story, okay? That is the truth. I think men who are in situationships are quick to post pictures of them and their boys than you and them together. That is the truth. You know what I'm saying? Like, and why is that? Why are men so comfortable doing that? You know, and why is that done? Or do they have a lot of women? You know, ladies, you have to give me a call and let me know. Men, you have to let me, if I could be wrong. I'm just trying to be real. You know, some of you guys are dealing with a lot of different women and you do not post pictures of any of those women. You guys go on trips with women. You got this lady taking pictures of you. So what you doing in Las Vegas by yourself? Okay? And it's the truth. Going on vacation and you don't post pictures of the person you're with. Why? Because you're in a situationship. And then you're going to say, well, I want nobody in my business. No, you want somebody else not in your business. That's what it is. And that's the truth. And I that's one thing I can't stand. Like, why not post those things? It's all in that social media world kind of drive us insane, to be honest with you. You know? We kind of fell into that trap because, let's see, 10 years ago, or maybe when social media just came out, nobody was caring about all that. Nobody was caring about who's posting what or whatever. But now, it's like rules to it. It's like rules to who you post with or where you at. That say you're not where you're supposed to be. Yo, it's just crazy. You know, we kind of fell into that trap, didn't we? This is La Rock on the radio. Sisterhood. Let's go. Have to jump this through. Smoking cigarettes. Writing something nasty on the wall. You nasty boy. He just sent it to the principal's office down the hall. Who's saying?
Why, you disagree with me?
You
go up
and learn that kind of thing, right?
Yeah. On the radio, Lady Bex is out right now celebrating her 5th year wedding anniversary. We're talking about situationships, actually talking about relationships, you know what I'm saying? One thing I wanted to bring up is that, you know, aren't we all searching for the same thing? You know, is no one out there searching for love anymore? You know, are we still loving people up, or what are we just doing? You know, I think situationship, I'm so mad that's even a freaking word, you know? Why can't we have real relationships? Why aren't we courting again? What's wrong with that? I feel like, you know, we lost that somewhere. You know, I listen to older people talk about things and courting and dating and stuff like that. Now I know people got down back in those days or whatever, I know. But was it really like this? You know, why has dating come so daggone complicated? You know, why can't you just say out front about getting your feelings hurt that you want to be in a relationship? Like, you want to have a boyfriend, you want to have a girlfriend. Why must we all be ashamed of saying that now? How come no one wants to catch feelings? It's like that song. How come all the songs are about just, you know, sex?
I mean, okay, mind you, I like some of those songs, okay? But why but why is it, it's not, you know, why aren't these songs, like, about getting into relationships, you know? The generation right now is like, nobody even wants that anymore, you know? Like, are there boyfriend and girlfriends anymore in the younger generation? Are we still having that? I think it's important that we do, you know? I think it definitely affects how we choose our partners as we get older, you know? Now, speaking from experience, and I told you about, you know, my situationships and how I'm not looking forward to that anymore. Because all in all, you know, 10 years go by really fast. 20 years go by really fast. Just yesterday I was 17, you know? So it's like years go by so fast. Why do you want to keep playing around, right? Time waits for no one, okay? So, you know, why not start building with someone right now? Why are we afraid to build with someone? Why waste time? And that's why I know the violator who called up. He said you have to love yourself and you have to love God first. And that's just the truth, you know, so you can kind of figure out what you want and things will come to you. You just have to believe that, ladies. It's La Rock. It's the Sisterhood Radio. I miss my Lady Bex. Boo hoo hoo. I ain't never doing this again. No. Just kidding. Anyway, call me up. 347-708-0216. We are live listening to Stevie.
La Rock, I got a question for you.
Oh my gosh. Did you hear that? Yes.
So what is it that keeps these young couples from not being couples? That's what I want to know.
That's what I want to know too. I think it's the way the young generation is seeing relationships. Like, maybe their own parents were in a situationship and that's how they got here. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like it's something that's trickled down. And I don't know, like, I don't know why it's not accepting to be with someone. Like, I don't know how it was, you know, I don't think I'm trying to think about when in the early 90s or in the 90s, how it was with, in like, talking about teenagers or whatever, like their teenagers, right? And like in the 20s, it just wind up being in somebody you just mess with. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That's right. All it was. Oh, I just mess with her. I just mess with her. How can we do this? How can we just be so intimate with people and don't want any emotion involved anymore?
I think it has to do with losing principles and values.
Okay.
Okay, in the right. Culture. You know, we had a time period where the crack epidemic really destroyed families. Okay, and from that, relationships were lost.
Right.
Okay, and a lot of people feared getting involved in a relationship for that fear that it wouldn't last, or that person get cracked out and now they got to start all over again. Mm. And I think they instilled that in some of the children that they were raising at the time.
And you know, that whole period is a lot of fatherless children.
Absolutely.
During that entire period.
Absolutely.
And next thing you know, we have men who are grown now are still dealing with that situation.
Right.
Men and women are right. Still dealing with that situation even now. And something happened to our community that we did not want relationships. And you know what? I could be talking about marriage. Maybe I'm talking about marriage. You know, I'm all about marriage, you know, being once married. but I think something happened to the, what Al just said, something happened to our community that we kind of just drifted away from love, from loving each other. And from that building and that growing in relationships, something happened. And then now we have a generation who are now happy with songs that are just saying, let's just be in situationships. You know what I'm saying? And so let's think about that. Hello? Let's think about that. What do you think, Al?
Well, again, you know, like I said, I know it has to do with
his voice,
you know,
is amazing, by the way.
The culture that we come up in and all the things that happened during mm-hmm. that time. But still, like Chris said, you know, a woman has to love herself.
Right.
And not just love yourself because you're beautiful, but love yourself because of what you can offer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then once you understand who you are, you got to be truthful with yourself. Okay, you can't meet a, say to yourself, okay, I'm looking for this in a relationship, and then you meet a man and you're so infatuated with them, you throw your principles out the door.
Right.
And then when he doesn't give you what you expect, now is a problem in a relationship.
I'm totally about that.
You know?
However, what do we do about the men that allow that? The men that will see a woman do that? Like, what does that tell us about the dynamic between the women and men? Like, what is... the man has a role in that too.
Absolutely, but the it's simple. That man doesn't have a relationship with God. He doesn't have a spiritual side.
Right.
Because if a man have a spiritual God side, he will love you because of what he know God can give you.
I believe that.
And once he loves you on that level, then he'll work with you to obtain everything in that relationship that you both would like to have.
Right. I believe that 100%, and that makes a lot of sense. It makes a lot of sense. Oh, I love that sound, y'all. Is somebody calling and trying to talk to me? Hey, what's up? This is The Rock, and this is the Sisterhood Radio. Who's calling?
Hello?
Hello, it's The Rock. What's up? This is the Sisterhood.
Caller?
You're live.
I'm live.
Hello?
Hello?
Hey, Sling.
Who is this?
Tamira.
Oh, what's up, honey? My name is LaRock on the radio, though.
LaRock.
What's up? This is one of my this is one of my vegan soul sisters. If you haven't known, if you know me, y'all, you'll know that I've chosen a different lifestyle. I've been a vegan now for 2 months now. Thank you, sweet black Jesus, because it has been super hard. And this is my girl right here who is on the Vegan Soul Sisters, founder of the group. What's up, honey? What's up? What's going on?
Listen, I was just listening and wanted to chime in a little bit.
All right. Well, go ahead. She is visiting from Oakland, California. What's up?
Yeah. So I think that the topic that you're discussing is very multifaceted, and I think that there are more elements to it than just one thing in particular.
Right.
And I agree with Al.
Yes. And that Barry White voice, that's Al, not me.
I agree that something happened, and I think that part of it, it was the crack epidemic and all of what that entailed in terms of breaking down the family or the structure of the black family.
Right.
But I also think that it is a lot of times in that time, grandma, papa, they stayed together. They weren't always happy.
Right.
And that was witnessed. Mm. It was witnessed that papa was even with the neighbor down the street, and you know, he had three kids with them and five kids in his own household. And so I think that that had part of it to do with it as well, in terms of me looking, seeing that, going, you know what, I don't really want that kind of love. It's
right.
That love.
Right.
And so kind of like what we did when, you know, we witnessed our grandparents or whoever who doing a lot of hard punishment in the household.
Right.
And when we came up, we said, we don't want to do that to our children.
Right.
So we stopped doing that. And we are reaping some of the results of not having a stronger hand in our household, just like I think we're reaping some of the results of not understanding that what the dynamic of those relationships were in those households that stayed together, even though things weren't always okay.
Right. And what when I was mentioning before, like, we know the same behaviors. Like, this is nothing new, right? These behaviors have been going on for centuries.
Right.
We understand that. But why is it so acceptable right now? Why is it acceptable amongst everyone to have these type of relationships that have no type of emotions behind it? Now, why are we for it? Why are women settling for this? And I'm saying women because I feel like women more settle for these things rather than men. And, you know, we knew that, you know, grandpa or granddaddy or whatever, we know he was a Rolling Stone. Okay, that's why they made the song up. You know? But why is it more accepting now And also not to be in relationships, you know? And there may not be an answer for that. You know, that just may, it's just how things are right now. But I'm feeling there's a lot of brokenness in that. You know, I don't think there's any satisfaction in that. The satisfaction that you are giving, I take that back. The satisfaction that you are giving is probably sexual satisfaction or the satisfaction of not trying to be hurt, but you wind up being hurt anyway. What do you think?
Right. I mean, I think it's a little unfair to put so much of the burden on women. We're nurturers. We were created for family. We were created for that one-on-one connection. So yes, a lot of times we do settle because of that. I feel like men need to stand up. They need to stand up and they need to be men. They need to stop asking women to deny themselves in order to be in these situationships. Why do I have to do something different? If I'm giving you everything that I have, why must I change in order to accommodate you when it's you who needs to change to accommodate me?
I know that's right. I love that.
Yeah, well, like I was saying, if a man truly loves a woman and he desires to be with her, he will make that sacrifice. He will make that sacrifice. But again, that sacrifice comes from a spiritual side, knowing what God has given him.
Right.
And again, like I said, if he don't have a relationship with God and he has a bigger relationship with the streets, you're not going to get that from him. You know, because he's going to go by what his boys is telling him. Oh, don't do that for her, man. You're a sucker. Oh, if you do that, man, she's going to take advantage of you. You know, they hear these things.
Right.
So they try to protect their heart and their person at the same time, you know. And what happens is they wind up losing out because you got to understand, once you lay with someone, y'all are spiritually connected.
Mm-hmm.
You could talk about you don't have no feelings all you want to, but that's not the truth.
Uh-huh.
Okay, and that's why there's so much domestic violence nowadays, because men aren't honest about their feelings,
right.
And women feel like, okay, well, since I don't get it from you, I'm going to go elsewhere and do it with somebody else, and now he's hurt, so now he's coming back, oh, why are you sleeping with this one? I thought we had this one and that, you know? So, again, those situations ain't what they appear to be.
No, they're not. And that's when we always go back to that self-love, right? We always go about self-love, it goes back to having God within ourselves, because if we don't have those elements, we wind up being broken people, and broken people jumping into relationships, and then broken people having children, okay? And that being trickled down to your children, and it goes on. And that's why it's so important that we have to love ourselves. And I'm talking to the women right now, and I know there's men out there who are broken too, okay? But who my circle is around is a lot of women, and a lot of my sisters are dealing with the same thing, okay? And I really need us to, you know, pass it down to our children, because most of my friends are mothers. And so pass it down to our children, this self-love. It's important. It's in every aspect of our life, even simple things simple and complex, I guess, is kind of both of them, and as relationships. And it starts really early. It starts really early, okay? And so, listen, Tamara, I thank you for calling, sweetie. Please continue on watching me on live. I thank you so much. You are my vegan soul sister, always.
Absolutely.
I'll see you in the chat group. All right, you too. Bye-bye. Everybody, this is The Sisterhood. We're live right now from the Bronx. iAccess Radio, The Sisterhood Radio. I'm Lady Bex. Lord, I'm not. I am LaRock. See how much I miss you. I am LaRock on the radio, and we are live. Listen to Stevie Wonder, y'all. We love him.
I'm
up, give me a call. This is the Sisterhood Radio, 347-708-0216. Call me live right now. Ladies, give me a call. Men, give me a call. Y'all always call anyway. But give me a call. We're talking about situationships. That's what we're talking about. And, you know, overall, we're talking about relationships, right? Right? We are talking about that. And the one question I have out there for whoever is listening is like, what do we really want? What are we really looking for? And I'm saying that because, you know, we think that we have youth on our side in most things, but I'm trying to tell you guys that, you know, it just came to me, actually, that we all get older, right? We all get older. Are we satisfied with where we are in respects to relationships? Are we satisfied? And we want just everyone to be happy. I want everybody to be happy. Don't you want to be happy? So what makes you happy? Is your situationship making you happy, or are you wasting your time? A lot of us waste our time. A lot of us waste our time in these situationships thinking we're going to get something. We don't get nothing, you know? And, you know, a lot of us are basically with the wrong people, you know, who they don't know what they want either. You know, we have to communicate well with each other, too. Let's do that. This is the Sisterhood Radio. I'm live right now from the Bronx. 347-708-0216. I'm going to memorize that number one of these days. Listening to Stevie all night long. Hey guys, we're back. This is La Rock on the radio. This is the Sisterhood Radio on iAccessRadio.com. If you'd like to be a guest on the show, please email us. That's La Rock and Lady Betts. The Sisterhood Speaks at gmail.com. Email us and we'll send you some back for the details. It's the Sisterhood, sister spelled S-I-S-T-A-H-O-D-D, Sisterhood. I mean, that's about it, right? H-O-D, speaks, at gmail.com. I'll put it on our Facebook page and also our Instagram. Please follow us on Instagram at the Sisterhood Radio. And then follow us at the Sisterhood with La Rock and Lady Becks on Facebook. Make sure you like both pages and follow us on both. We only are here. We are unbossed and unbothered. Okay, we're here to empower, inspire, and to support the Black womanhood and culture. And that's why we're here. You know, just to give you a little background, if you are new to listening to the Sisterhood, it's usually we are a duo. We're actually, it's three of us. It's a duo. Our DJ is not here, but Al is doing so great.
Thank you.
And I do appreciate him so much. I'm not feeling too bad. But usually it's La Rock and DJ All-Star. They have the night off, which is amazing. Lady Bex and I started this show because we wanted to empower Black women. And a lot of our conversations were based on everyday life. We talk on the phone every single day, every morning. And we kind of have so many conversations and that help us both out. In particular me, it helps me out a lot. And so, you know, we had shows that are about basically everything. But I think right now it all goes back to that show that we did on self-love. I think if we get that down, you know, it would just broaden our eyes a little bit, wouldn't it? We all have to look forward to that self-love and keep on doing it and loving ourselves. It's very important and something we have to, you know, talk to our children about, our boys and our daughters about self-love. We don't realize how much that we need that in our daily lives, you know. Just thinking about it right now, something as simple as making decisions, we really have to look and make sure we care about ourselves and how we love ourselves and just to make just the simplest decisions, right? It all comes down to us. This is La Rock on the radio, the Sisterhood. Listen to more Stevie.
I'm asking for permission to lay something heavy on one's head. So I have tried to not be the one who fell into that line. But what I feel inside, I think you should know. And baby, that's you made life's history. 'Cause you brought some joy inside my tears. You have done what no one thought could be. You brought some joy inside my tears. I've always felt that tomorrow is for those who are too much afraid to go past yesterday and start living for today. Moments are coming, far and few between. So I should tell you of the happiness that it brings. Baby, it's you made life his story. Oh, baby, you brought me some joy. Inside my tears, baby, you have done what no one thought could.
ready.
Joy inside my dear.
Hey guys, it's The Rock on the Radio again. You know, I was just reading something, and we're talking about, you know, situationships and relationships, the difference between them, how come situationships are just what's available right now. Perhaps people may think it's easier, but are we really afraid of monogamy? Are we really afraid of being with just one person? I'm talking to the men now. Are you afraid that, not afraid, but do you guys don't want to make yourself available just to one person? Do you want to make yourself available to many people? And that's why you don't want the relationship. I'm sorry to single just men out, but I can't help it. And you don't have Lady Bex here to tell me to calm down. It's just going to be me. But I'm just wondering, is it afraid of monogamy, you know? Do we have that many failed relationships in the prior generation that we don't want to be in a marriage or want to be in a long-lasting relationship? Like, what's up with that? And I'm trying to figure that out because it seems like, you know, we're just going to that. We're just going to that. Can't think of the word right now, but we're all pushing for just to be in situations, you know, and nothing's like lasting long enough, and we're afraid of our emotions, and what's going on in our community that's happening so much, that so many of us are walking around here, you know, it seems as if we're broken, you know, and I definitely see that. And our children are affected by it, most definitely. So, anyway, give me a call back up. I sound so, like, melancholy, don't I? Oh, my gosh, my face all got sad. Jeez, I need to perk it up a little bit. It's 347-708-0216. It's the Sisterhood Radio. I am live right here from the Bronx. We're right here on iAccess Radio. Check us out every other Friday right here. We're live 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Usually here we have Lady Bex, who is out on her 5th year anniversary. Shout out to Lady Bex. Thanks for calling. Hope you're having a great weekend. I have to go to work tomorrow, so that's what I'm doing this weekend, going to work. But that's okay with me. We're here playing Stevie Wonder all night. Please call me 347-708-0216. Sisterhood. Maybe it was the song that got me sad. Stevie would do that to ya. Check it.
successfully by a black man. Then the man who died to help the pilgrims to survive was a red man.
Are back. Are you enjoying Stevie Wonder? Listen, if you know me like in real life, like for real, you know that I'm a huge Stevie Wonder fan. I think I really fell in love with Stevie Wonder and his music in college. Dealing with just love relationships, probably a situationship, and wondering why I was not getting into a relationship. That was all about me. I was so a romantic in college. Still am a bit. But yeah, we're playing Stevie all night. He's absolutely my favorite. Just want to tell you guys this. If you are a R&B artist, hip hop artist, if you are someone who has, their own business, female in particular, okay? Cause this is the Sisterhood Radio and we want our black sisters to promote what they got. We want you guys to be successful. We just want to be great together. You know what I'm saying? And so Lady Bex and I would like you and welcome you to the show. You just have to email us, thesisterhoodspeaks@gmail.com. If you do hair, nails, waist trainers, whatever, and you want to promote your business, we're all about that. Isn't that all about, what is that, Kukujakalia? That's self-determination. Umoja Ujima. What is like something to deal with financial something? What's up to my people who celebrate Kwanzaa? But we want you guys to, cooperative economics, that's what it is. Call me if you know which one that was. I forget myself and I celebrate Kwanzaa. But we want you guys to come up and talk about your business and promote it. And then promote the show as well, okay? The Sisterhood Radio is all about supporting each other, uplifting each other, and inspiring each other. And, you know, we all want to be great. The world is not for us. And we know that. And we feel that every single day. So we created this show so we can support each other. To know that we all can be great. That black women can be great. We are a beautiful people.
be on the front lines of everything. And although the background music says a black man, he can't be nothing about a black woman. Trust and believe that. Okay? It's The Rock on the Radio with Labex on vacation. The Sisterhood Speaks at gmail.com. Email us right now.
The father of Blood Plasma and the director of the Red Cross Blood Bank.
Everybody, it's The Rock on the Radio. This is The Sisterhood. We're winding down just a little bit right now, but I want us all to kind of reflect on what we were saying tonight. You know, it all comes down to self-love when we come down to these relationships. Relationships are hard. They're very difficult. But does it really have to be? You know, I think, you know, we have to really realize who we are before we jump into different things. Because we don't, it does complicate anything. And, you know, I hate when people say love complicates stuff. No, it doesn't. You know, I'm a firm believer that God is love. So I don't believe love complicates anything. I think we do it to ourselves. You know, and that's why it's very important that we really use that self-love for every single thing in our life. You know, you could be in a very happy marriage. You could be, but you still need to love yourself. Okay? Even in that, and continue to do so. And be supportive to each other in that marriage and in that relationship. A lot of us, you know, marriages do not last, unfortunately, because of different things, you know. Personally, I believe that, you know, self-love was lacking with myself, you know, as a young 20-something-year-old, you know. That's why we have to talk to our youth right now. We got to talk to our young sisters right now and talk about self-love. So they can make, you know, better choices in their life and talk to these men too. I know I leave the men out a lot because I see more women suffering than men, but I know it's both of us. And so we have to talk to our sons. What do we say to our sons and our daughters about relationships, even at very young ages? What do we say? Do we start talking about relationships with other people, or do we start off with saying self-love? In my opinion, we should start teaching that self-love, like from jump. Now that we know the effects of it when we don't have it, we know the effects when the community doesn't have it. You know, we know the effects on the community. You know, we got a caller. That's awesome. Hi, you have reached the Sisterhood Radio live with LaRock. Why'd you hang up? That wasn't nice. Did you get shy? Got the wrong number? You didn't get the wrong number. Call me back. 347-708-0216. A lot of people don't know that my name is LaRock. and that's how I introduce myself. But I am LaRock Lewis, LaRock on the Radio. And we're talking about the sisterhood. And listening to Stevie Wonder, which got me in a certain type of mood, you know? I think Stevie Wonder, he just, you know, one thing about these songwriters, between Stevie Wonder and like Jill Scott, they like speak to you. Solange too. That's someone, you know, this generation would know. We we listen to these words because everyone deals with the same thing. And that's why they're so powerful. These lyrics that come out these songs is so powerful because we've gone through these things. That's why, you know? I think when I was younger singing these songs, I really didn't know what this was all about, but daggone it, Stevie, we know what this mess is all about. If it's magic, my gosh. The Sisterhood Radio. Call me, 347-708-0216. It's the Sisterhood Radio Live, iAccessRadio.com. Oh, I love this song. We have to play this one all the way through.
Like the sun that always shines, like the poet's endless rhyme, like the galaxies in time. If it's pleasing, then why can't it be never leaving? Like the day that never fails, like on seashores there are shells, like the time that always tells. It holds the key to every heart throughout the universe. It fills you up without a bite and quenches every If it's special, then with it, why aren't we as careful as making sure we dress in style, posing pictures with a smile, keeping danger from a child. It holds the key to every heart throughout the universe. It fills you up without a bite and quenches every thirst.
So on my ID right now, this is a rock right now. We're on a
if it's magic, why can't we make it everlasting?
347-708-0216.
Like the lifetime of the sun.
347-708-0216. We're live right now.
Undone. For there's enough for everyone.
And we're back. Oh, and I love that song too. Are we making y'all sad? We don't want to do that. We just love Stevie. He's great. Maybe this listening to Stevie Wonder will get you into a relationship. Get out of these situationships. It'll make you realize, you know, I do love him. Oh, I do love her. You know? Perhaps you'll have a family. Yay. Anyway, got me feeling a certain mood too. Oh my God. We got to get back to some hip hop. Anyway, this is the Sisterhood Radio. We are live. We are ending our show soon. I want to thank everybody who called in. I definitely appreciate you. We have about 10 more minutes. It's 347-708-0216. This is the Sisterhood Radio. We're live right here from the Bronx. We are unbossed and unbothered. We're here to inspire. We're here to... hi. We're here to inspire. We're here to empower. We're here to support Black women in culture. Listen, if you want to be a guest in our show and you are from the New York City area, I want you right now to send me an email. TheSisterhoodSpeaks@gmail.com. TheSisterhood, S-I-S-T-A, HoodSpeaks@gmail.com. Let us know what's up. You may be an inspiring actress. You might be on a come up of R&B, hip hop, spoken word. Send me your MP, send me your, or whatever you do in an MP3. We'll play it for free on the radio. If you want to become a guest, we'll send you some details about that. Okay? We want Black women to be great. Like I said before, the world does not see us as great, right? They never intended us to see us as great. You know what I'm saying? We were out there, but no one heard us. But people won't hear us today. We're going to hear us now. We're loud and clear. But we've always been there. Black woman has always, always been there. Always. Hey, what's up? I'm right now on Instagram at the Sisterhood Radio. Des Dingo, Lady Bex is not here, boo. She's out there being booed up this weekend. Happy 5th anniversary to her. That's wonderful. And we love love around here. I know I do. I do. I love love. I'm not booed up right now, though. But it's okay. That's why I'm here, live on the radio, to talk to y'all. Somebody has to hear me. Someone loves this laugh and smile and my voice. Is it y'all? Check me out right now. I'm live on the Sisterhood Radio on Instagram. Okay, so follow our page on Instagram. Follow us on Facebook. We're going to have a group starting soon on Facebook, and make sure you join that. Talking about all things that uplift, inspire, and support Black women. That's what we're here about. If you want to become on our show as a guest, please email us at thesisterhoodspeaks@gmail.com. We're going to be ending our show soon. Our show was about situationships and, and the difference between relationships. And I think we all know about these things. Everything that I said today was nothing made up. We all think about these things, you know. I wish people who called who were in situationships and kind of liked and enjoyed that. But is that healthy for us? How long can you go out with a situationship? How long is that going to last for you? Is that what you really want? Ladies, I'm talking to you. Is that what you really want? You know, it's all good and gravy. But next thing you know, you wind up being by yourself, you know. So, you know, maybe you're the type of woman like, I don't need anybody. Let me tell you something, sister. Everybody needs somebody, okay? We're tough people. Black women are tough. We are strong. We're independent. Yes, we are. But I don't believe this. We were meant to be alone. I really don't. Love was created. And I know we have love inside of us. God is love, y'all. Don't y'all know that? Okay? This is a sisterhood. We played Stevie all night long because I love Stevie. I love Stevie too. Shout out to our DJ. Hope you're having a good time. I know Bex. Lady Bex, I know you're having a good time. Shout out to everybody who's watching me right now on Instagram, the Sisterhood Radio. We're going to close out. This is probably the longest song Stevie Wonder has ever had. And I love this song right now. Check us out. We'll be back April 6th, God willing. We'll be here. We're talking about more things that empower Black women, more things that inspire Black women, more things that support Black women. We are unbossed and unbothered. You better believe it. This is La Rock on the radio, the Sisterhood.